بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله على النبي الأمي برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us during these trying times that we are facing. There's an interesting hadith, because every situation we face in life, we find the solution in our deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, after أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. Certainly for you in the Nabi of Allah is the perfect example. And there's so many emphasis in this verse. There's 6 emphasis. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to find the solutions in our deen, because certainly it is there. There's the Sahabi Abu al-Mukhariq radiyallahu anhu. His son's name was Qaboos. So Qaboos rahimahullah narrates from his father Abu al-Mukhariq, who says, I was in the company of Janabi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when a man came in and said, O Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if a man intercepts me, a man barges into my privacy, into my home, a man attacks me, he wants to usurp my wealth and endanger my family, endanger my life, what do I do? Mada asna, ma asna? Allah's Nabi said, Dhakirhu billahi azza wa jal, remind him of Allah, mention to him about Allah, tell him about the greatness of Allah. Meaning, tell him Allah is watching, Allah is one. We have to face the repercussions of our actions in the hereafter. So remind him about Allah. And if he refuses to take lesson and hearken and take heed, then ask other Muslims around you to help you against him. And if he still, or if there's no one to help you, then you fight and defend your wealth, meaning defend your wealth, your family, your property, your life. And if in that, in defending yourself, you die, you become the shaheed of the akhirah. Min shuhada il akhirah. And if not, you save your wealth. This is hadith is in Musnad Ahmad. So we learn from here that as Muslims, we are supposed to be strong. We are supposed to preserve our iman. And we are supposed to be stand up for our rights. It's inappropriate for us to be like sitting ducks, waiting, you know, with fear and so forth. As Muslims, the hadith states, المسلم القوي خير وأحب إلى الله من المؤمن الضعيف وكما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المؤمن القوي. A strong believer is better and more beloved to Allah. Yes, Allah loves all, but more beloved to Allah than one who's weak. Yes, what is intended in this hadith is strength of iman, but physical strength is also important, because a Muslim has to defend himself. Sahaba radiallahu anhum were strong people. And when we just give in and let people do what they want and take what they want and harm the way they want to harm, then they will come back and cause more harm. So yes, we are facing these trying times, these situations. Let us have the ability to stand up and protect ourselves and be strong, be courageous and fight back and stand up for our rights. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq.